on, it's Havoc with the HGC YouTube gaming channel. Today I'm just going to show you real quick where to get a ton of rare flowers, fiber, rare mushrooms, and silk. So just to kind of orient ourselves here, this is where we are on the map. GPS coordinates, 34 lat, 16.5 long, and we're heading from the Blue Obelisk right there, which is where a lot of people kind of start out on this map because that's where the easy zones are. And we're heading south along the coast. Here's a swamp area. And the only thing you really need to do this effectively is a Therizinosaur. You don't need a Wyvern, you just need a way to get down here to the swamp safely. And I've got a little area here that I've got fenced off. If you're not familiar with this is the dynamic fence mod. Really cool mod. I'm not going to get into it, but I highly recommend it. Really fun to use. You can use it to stun dinos that run into it or kill them. But like I said, I'm not going to get into it too much. I'm going to do a whole playlist of mods. So anyway, here's a Therizinosaur. One thing to know about the Therizinosaur is when you go into its radial menu and you go into view harvesting levels, you can choose to either put your points into power harvesting or delicate harvesting. I always recommend putting your points into delicate harvesting. Power harvesting is more for like gathering wood. And why have a Therizinosaur that specializes in gathering wood when there's the castoroids, you know, the beaver, or the woolly mammoth? So, that being said, the reason why this area is so great is because of, you know, all these cattails and all these trees. The cattails have the rare flowers in them, and the trees have the rare mushrooms in them. But really what I really want to show you guys is right over here, and I'll pull up the map again and the GPS unit again just so you can really figure out and pinpoint where this spot is at. So you see these blue flowers on the ground and the patches of purple flowers? These are going to give you a ton of rare flowers and silk. So I'm just going to run through here, and you're not going to be able to see it very easily. But there's just a ton of flowers. This whole area is just covered in them. So, yeah, you can watch the numbers on the left hand of the screen just go up. And rare flowers are really useful, especially when you have Akatina, I think it's pronounced, like the snails, when you have a snail farm, because they eat sweet vegetable cakes. And in order to make sweet vegetable cakes, you're going to need the rare flowers to power the beehives. Silk, you don't really need it for that much, that I can think of anyway. There's desert armor that you can build that requires silk. So anyway, yeah, as you can see, just tons of rare flowers and silk. Now I'll go and show you the difference between the Therizinosaur and the woolly mammoth when it comes to gathering wood. And, you know, to be honest, they probably gather rare mushrooms at close to the same rate. But the big benefit with the woolly mammoth is that it's much better at dealing with so much wood. Because when you go through here knocking down these trees, you have to empty out the Therizinosaur's inventory. It's just how the world works. Therizinosaur is not great. The woolly mammoth has a reduced weight buff that allows it to carry a lot more wood. And so it can carry a lot more mushrooms without having to empty its inventory as often. One thing to note also that I don't think I've mentioned, the Therizinosaur has three attacks actually, C, which is for getting berries out of plants. This is on PC. Left click on the mouse is its primary attack, and that's what you hit the trees with to get the mushrooms out. And then the secondary action, which is really gross looking, can't really see it, danglers, is for collecting fiber and flowers and stuff like that. So I'm overweight on my Therizino, so I gotta go in here and empty out all that wood. Okay, but you get the idea with that. And there's just tons of trees here. So you got the trees, the swamp trees for the mushrooms. You got all the cattails for rare flowers and fiber. And then you have that sweet area that's kind of shadowed by canopy that you can't see from the air and you can't really see from the ground, to be honest. And that's just full of flowers, so let's hop on the mammoth and see how well that forms. And the mammoth isn't going to help you with anything else except for getting the mushrooms out of the trees. So, and if you're familiar with the Ragnarok map, you don't really tame woolly mammoths very close to this area at all. So I had to actually transport my mammoth quite a distance to get it here. So here's its left, its primary attack, the left click on the mouse. I advise using the right click on the mouse. I just kind of feel like you get more mushrooms out of trees that way. I'm not positive. We'll do a little experiment here and see what happens. So this strike, like, got six out of that one, nothing out of that one, nothing out of that one, six out of that one. Okay, so now we're going to go to left click. So it looks like with left click, you actually get the rare mushrooms more consistently, but just not as much per strike. You know what? So actually, left click might actually be better. But yeah, so getting rare mushrooms at a pretty nice pace. So, I mean, that's it. Oh, you know what? Here, let me give you the specific coordinates of that little area over there. Hop on my Wyvern and just go over there and get you the GPS coordinates. That way you can pinpoint yourself straight to that. And if you have, if you do have a Wyvern and you don't want to build this little setup here, you can just pick up your Thrizen sword just fine and fly it over here and collect it and then fly the Thrizen sword back to your base. That's what I did for a while. The only thing I use my Thrizen sword for is getting fiber and rare flowers, so it's like, might as well just leave it here. Okay, let's bring up the GPS map. So we're at about 3819. So that's it. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.